Welcome back to FG Detective channel, and today I'm here with another tip for you. I'm here, as you can see, again with my Ninebot ES2, and you probably already saw some other videos I did on this scooter, for example the speed check and how to properly do the maintenance on this scooter. If you didn't, you can check them anyway here on the upper right corner. Today anyway, I'm gonna show you how to solve what is probably the most annoying issue I have with this scooter, which is the terrible clack sound you can hear every time you have a pedal or a crack in your pass. The procedure is quite simple and is reversible, it's really inexpensive. So follow me and let's check what we need for this mod. What? Why don't you show them first what you mean with this terrible clack sound? Okay, so let's first check what I mean with this terrible clack sound. Okay, now let's check what we need for this mod. So for the front suspension, we just need a couple of things: electrical tape, an elastic rope, and just some scissors. First of all, let's open the rubber protection. Now some electrical tape for fixing it. Okay, now we have enough space for working here. As we said, we need an elastic rope. This is around 4 millimeters thick. As we can see, we can also use some silicone plastic tubes, transparent tubes that are usually used for water tanks, but I find this one better, as I think will be a most durable solution. You can probably see here that inside is full of elastic, so it should enhance a little bit the suspension. Let's now check how long we need it to be. So we basically need 20-21 centimeters. Let's cut it. Now we just need to fix it. So as we said, this is the 4 millimeter one. As you can see, there is still a little bit of play in the suspension. If you use a 6 millimeters, basically you don't have any play here, there won't be any gap anymore. You might also use the 3 millimeter or version, that would be fine as well, or even the 5 millimeter version, but not 6 millimeters, as I said. So I went in between with the 4 millimeter one. Yeah.
The first part is already fixed. Let's now fix the second part of the rope. And now the final one. Just for being on the safe side, let's just tuck in here a second layer. So second layer of electric tape. Obviously you need a small diameter like this one in order to ease the wall operation. Okay, we are basically done. We can now remove the rest of the tape that we just used for the rubber protection of the suspension. And now let's put it back in position. We need the help of a small screwdriver in case you really want to perfectly position this rubber. Okay, left side is in. Let's do the same for the opposite side. Okay, you will hear basically a click when it's in. Now it's ready. Let's look now at the rear suspension and let's see how we can make its regulation. So we can potentially do the same mod we did on the front, also for the back, for the rear suspension, but I don't suggest doing that. What I suggest is to regulate a little bit the play of this suspension. And this can be easily done with a Allen key, number 8, as this one. So simply, if you screw it, you will have less play, so it will tighten a little bit the wall driving mode. If you unscrew it, it will be more soft, but pay attention not to unscrew it too much. Otherwise, you can have the bottom part of the scooter touching on the street, and therefore you will see it in a lot of scratches in here. That's how you can also understand if you need to screw or unscrew. In my case, I already know I need to screw this a little bit. Okay, that should be enough. And basically you continue playing with it until you find the good balance. That also depends on the driver weight, obviously, but that should work for me. So now the only thing left is to test it. Let's get out.
I hope the video was useful and you could actually hear and recognize the difference of the sound before the mod and after the mod, but if not, believe me, there is a tremendous difference. I hope anyway the video was helpful for you guys. If you like it, please hit the bell in order to get notified about new videos, and please subscribe in order to support the channel. That's all I have for you today, and as always, see you in the next one. We'll be right back.